This
Can you
conference will
go
now be
and say that
recorded.
this, if they back to you saying pointing out any deficiencies, it can be assumed that they have accepted it. So that is the procedure as far as electrical inspectorate is concerned. Now, Sandhya, what else you want me to talk about?
I would like to enlighten something
Sandhya?
more, sir. See,
before
as
that,
per the
may I
new,
ask Sandhya?
As per the recent or 2012 Lift Amendment Act is concerned for Karnataka Lift Acts, it has been made compulsory to submit every year the annual AMC report to them. The contract paper need to be submitted to the Chief Electrical Inspectorate. And your license is 10
I'm
years.
I'm not sure if it is.
Yeah, please.
No, it is not every year. I think it is every 5 years. Every
sir, please check it. Lift
years.
Act
I'm not
says.
Really sure about
lift
that.
Lift
yeah,
Act
I'll
says.
I'll do that. Okay.
Lift Act says it is every
okay.
year. AMC contract paper need to be submitted.
Submitted electrical inspectorate. I'm not very sure about
yes,
that.
Yes, to the
it
electrical
was, all these years, it was every all these years it was 5 years. I don't know if it has changed. I'm not very sure.
AMC is every year you are doing it, so that is made compulsory under the Lift Act. AMC.
AMC of that is otherwise the contractor will not maintain your listing unless it is as you renew it. So that is the as far as the electrical inspectorate stipulations are concerned, I don't think it has to be submitted every year. I think 5 years. Sandhya, any you want me to cover? Sandhya? Hello. Sandhya had suggested that I talk a little more about BESCOM and its the whole the problem with it. Now I don't know
your solution to it.
Shall I project my?
Hello.
We'll have to ask. Vikram or Ajay to make me a
right?
Yeah. Okay. Now this is a subject now. Okay. And in Karnataka, now you know how the power situation is, okay? I have made two slides, just, okay, leave it at this. Yeah, no, yes, okay, fine. Hello, some disturbance there. Okay.
A request to everyone to please keep your speakers on mute. A lot of static from behind is coming. Hence, we are muting everybody. Any questions, please put it on the chat window. We should be able to get back to you on the queries that you put here. Thank you. Mr. Muralidhar, you could probably unmute yourself and talk now. Thank you.
Murli, can you unmute yourself? Murli, are you there?
Network, it's a
Sandhya, can you go ahead with the presentation, please? Till Murli comes back.
Sure.
No, there is a there seems, I think, I mean, it is going on and off my mic. I don't know why. Sandhya, can you go to the first slide? Chart. That alone will do for me. The first chart. Or make me the presenter. Next one. This will do. Yeah. Fine. No. Yeah, fine. I had made an estimate. You know, we in Mantri Classic, where I'm living, okay, we are 140 apartments, and diesel, because of the unreliability of the BESCOM power supply, at the rate of about 360 liters every month. Now, extrapolating across the BAF and across the city, it works out to 11 million liters of diesel every year. Okay, and for domestic sector alone, now when you say 11 million, 11,000 tankers, okay, that's a kind of this diesel that we are consuming, okay, in a year. Now, it's a colossal waste. Now, that is where, you know, things have turned around totally. Now, that is the situation in Bangalore. Now, look at it in other cities, like Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Surat, Kolkata, Greater Noida, etc. And the latest is Delhi. Now, Delhi in 2002, the Sheila Dixit government decided that, you know, this won't do and we need to, the losses there. Now you can see this chart. In 2002, it was 53.1, okay? And so she decided, I mean, things have to change. And what did she looked around the country and found that in Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Surat, etc., there is excellent power supply. And what is common about them was it was all PPPs or lastly private sector. So she decided that's the only way out and it went about in the proper process. Okay. Delhi was divided into four districts. The Lutyens Delhi remained with Desu. The rest of Delhi was divided into three districts. One was taken by Tatas. And two were taken up by Reliance. Now at that stage were only in generation, so they didn't have much of a distribution. Only one district. Now Reliance was already working in Mumbai, so they had the experience. So they took on two districts. Now from 2002 to today, it's now March 17. You can see the transformation that has happened in at least the areas covered by Tatas. Now Reliance is slightly backwards, but it was not Mukesh Ambani, it was Anil Ambani. Anil Ambani didn't do a proper job of it, and really he sold it to Adani. Okay, now all that is another story, but I'll tell you about at least what Tatas have done. You can see what Tatas have done. You can see it on this one snapshot itself. Now, the losses, what were in the range of about 53.1 has now reduced to 8.59. Okay, now this is called, there's another term for it, T&D losses, transmission distribution losses. Actually, the euphemism was, it was called theft and dacoity losses. It was essentially thieving that was going on. And she brought down to 8. Now you can do all the process here. There is a improvement across across the board. System reliability now near 100%. That means you can junk all your genset, inverter, converter, candles, matchsticks, everything. So that is how it is. You can see it here. Then transformer failure already. Length of network, they have expanded three times. Streetlight functionality, again, almost near 100%. New connection, energization time, just 5 days from, it was 51 days earlier. In just 5 days, provisional billing, you see, defective bills, nil, bill compliance, every aspect of it has transformed. And that is the kind of, you know, the supply we should be looking for. And not every day, at least in Kormangala now, we are facing, at least there is this white topping work going on, because of which these things are getting repeatedly switched off and cables are getting cut and all those kinds of problems are there. That will not happen if the services are with a company. PPP, okay, that is the difference. Now, okay, now you, I mean, can you go ahead? Next slide. Go back to the, yeah, and the, yeah, on a comparison, next slide. On a comparison for all the claims made by Power Minister, there is in Karnataka, every one of the 22 odd participants from across the section, and they held on 50, openly complained of serious power interruptions even in February, requiring huge dependency on gensets. Now, this is what I had said. Liters per month of diesel, 11 million liters per annum for domestic sector alone. That is, and being blown up in smoke, okay? And adding to the pollution. This is the state. Next slide, Sandhya. Yeah, now you can see the tariff in, this is Bangalore, this is Delhi. You can see for the lower things, now currently Arvind Kejriwal government has reduced this to less than 1 rupee. Okay, and we are at, this is the position in 2017, I think. Okay, currently we are at about 6 rupees, 90 paisa or something like that at that rate. So you can see the difference. And this is, mind you, for 100% reliable power supply. Next slide, Sadhya. Next slide. Next slide. Okay, I'll tell you now. Yeah, now all of this is, see, why this is happening. This is the kind of having in, that's a picture, but Karnataka is no better. If you see our transformer installations, how bad, you can see from that picture. Now, the problem largely, okay, ACCOM in the city, okay, in BESCOM in the city, the losses are not too bad actually. Now, but what's happening is when you say it is not covering just Bangalore city, covering Chitradurga, Kolar, and all the districts around Bangalore. Okay. And now in all of those, it is the agricultural load. And in agricultural load, up to 10 HP, there is even. So done is the estimate, say 3,000 crores or something like that. The government is supposed to pay BESCOM, okay, on an annual basis. So not 3,000 annum or something like that. Now, the problem is that they don't pay it on time, which leaves the BESCOM totally broke always. Now, that leads to all of the that we have, okay, in the distribution. In fact, there is a court case pending now, none less than the vice president of he is one of the church, and during a rain, he after the rain subsided, he stepped on a puddle which was adjacent to a transformer, and with the leakage of current from the transformer, he was electrocuted and there. That and his first claim from BESCOM 32 and the matter is still lying in court. They have not paid it. So that is the situation. And mind you, this is not an isolated instance. There have been many more deaths too. And the kind of way BESCOM is maintaining these transformers, it is inevitable that you will have far many, many, many more such accidents apart from interruptions that we have. So the I had attended the meeting. Turnover of 1,679 crores of Karnataka. Now I will expect that many of you understand. Go back to that earlier slide. Next slide. Next. Yeah. Leave. Next. After. Okay. I and that, 2002 was this unbundling. That means earlier it was all, go back. Earlier it was all under one Karnataka Electricity Board. It was decided by the central government. These functions have to be unbundled. That is, the generation has to be with a separate company. So, and the transmission has to be with a separate entity, and the distribution has to be with a separate entity. So KEB was Karnataka Electricity Board, KSEB at that stage, was unbundled into Karnataka Power Corporation, which was a generation company. Then KPTCL, which
hello. Sandhya, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I have sent a message on the chat.
Yeah.
Can close this in another 5-10 minutes on the privatization.
Yes. Yeah.
The more important thing that we have to discuss is the advice regarding maintenance. Sir, 1 minute. Lift maintenance, transformer maintenance, and other allied subjects as far as the electricity is concerned. Kindly.
I'll complete.
Murli, can we now, since we don't have too much time, can we go back to the BESCOM compliances and summarize those, please? Hello, Murli.
Sandhya, can you hear me? Mr. Rao, can you hear me? Sandhya, can you hear me?
Murli, are you with us? Hello. Looks like he's having some challenges. Shankar? Shankar? Can you unmute yourself, please? Ajay, I think Shankar needs help in unmuting.
Hello, I just want to conclude with the last presentation, last slide in the presentation, Sandhya. No.
Okay.
Hello.
Sir, your time is up. Can you just summarize the compliances part, please?
Let us discuss more about the compliances
What's
part.
Happening? Ajay.
Mr. Murlidhar Rao.
Hello. Murli, can you?
Go down.
Can you summarize the compliances part, please?
Opposite direction. Towards the end of my presentation. The last slide of my presentation. In that.
Okay, go ahead with the last slide, sir.
Since we...
Last slide.
Go ahead with the last slide and then take up the compliances.
Is this a part? Hello. Sorry.
So shall I start?
We're still having problems. Yeah, please go ahead.
Am I audible?
Yes, Shankar, very much. Please go ahead.
Okay. Mine is, the points are very straightforward, two or three only. So most of us are aware of what are the kind of NOCs that we are going through from a fire department. We normally have a stage when before construction, when a new building comes up, we get an initial NOC from the fire services department. Then after the construction completion takes place, one more inspection takes place by the fire department and we have a final NOC. And this is something which is related to new buildings. But for existing buildings, the concept of clearance certificate every 2 years came up after the Carlton fire incident. So the Karnataka High Court mandated that every 2 years, this mandate was issued sometime in June of 2011. Actually, the High Court order came in June 2011 and the government issued a notification on July 2011 asking the government to make sure that every 2 years all apartments and high rises are inspected and a clearance certificate given. So this is a subject that has been pending for quite some time, although the notification came in 2012. Between 2012 and 2015, what has been happening is the fire department was expected to give some information to the government, to the High Court, on the number of buildings and what is their status, and all this information that they compiled took almost till probably end of 2015, when actually is the time that they started approaching us apartments as far as inspection for clearances are concerned. But unfortunately, what happened is in 2017 and 2019 they introduced two systems of tariffs which are too heavy, and most of us apartments were never able to go forward and get this inspection done. So this is one thing that has been an issue for most of us who are existing apartment owners. And this is a topic in which we are trying to also talk to the fire department. And two, three things came out of our discussion is, one is that we requested them that we wanted to really challenge the excessive tariff that they have proposed, for which they have agreed in principle that we can make a representation to the government. The second thing is, everybody has been bogged down with a 40% training story. Even last week, I had people calling me and inquiring about it, saying that 40% training of residents is something people are in the fire department are holding before issuing a clearance certificate. But this is something which has been put on hold by the fire department until the issue about how this has to be done is clearly settled. Because we have been telling the fire department it is not possible for people to go to the training academy of Munpur at Bannerghatta Road. And so what they also accepted is that they will try to get empaneled vendors who can be used by the apartments for getting their inspections done. Unfortunately, this is something where no movement has happened. And even as late as Thursday of the week that has gone by, I was trying to talk to the DGP Fire Services to inquire where we are. And the system seems to be still in a status quo. And so we are not in a position as to pursue with them and get the empaneled vendors list as of yet. So this is an area where we are trying to talk to them. But on talking on a more specific issues related to us in the fire story is, we have three issues. One is inspection, about which we just talked about. Second is about training. And third is about fire drills. These three are issues where we must pay attention at least. And while for inspection, we are still waiting. And for training, we have been proposing something to them. What we need to do is, fire drills is an area where we must, at least apartments must take interest. Because if we conduct regularly fire drills, there is a chance that we can go and make a representation to them to say that we are conducting fire drills and our fire drills are successful. That means most of us are aware of what are the requirements for handling our fire system. So we can push them as far as inspection clearances are concerned. So this is the summary that I wanted to share with you. And we also spoke to the fire department about the NOC issues related to older apartments. There are many apartments, even probably not very old also, who do not have an NOC because probably the builder went away and they were left without having a proper NOC and an occupancy certificate. So for all this, what is advised to us was that these can be only handled on a case-by-case basis, for which each of us have to provide some kind of a template document where we say what is the history of that particular apartment complex is. Unless we do that, we will not be able to pursue for individual old apartments or apartments that they do not have an NOC. So one of the first things that I wanted to suggest is for all these apartments, at least they must make sure that they go and check how their fire system is, and they must get a fire system survey that they must take part in or show interest in. From BAF side, we have done some fire surveys for almost 70, 80 apartments. At least this is something that can give each of the apartments some kind of an idea how they are placed as far as their fire safety systems are concerned. So unless this comes forward, then probably we are able to, each of the apartments are able to find out where they stand as far as fire safety is concerned, and then whether they are needing, requiring to take any more steps to improve that, so that they put their case as a fit case where NOC can be requested or approach can be made to the fire department for an NOC. So this is one area where we wanted to actually pursue from BAF side as a, in the group. So I am also trying now since the last 1 month or so to try to find out if most of the apartments who have not volunteered so far can come forward and take interest in this, so that we do, at least for the sake of many of these apartments, we know what is their health check. And if there is a reason that their fire safety is not all that great, they can go for a greater, more deeper fire safety audit through some of the specialized companies that are available. One or two we have also been talking to. And then as a next step, we can approach the fire department on a case by case. So this is where we are trying to push as far as the fire department is concerned. So if there are queries and people are asking, what is it that is they have as an issue, I am prepared to take some questions and answer.
I have a specific issue. In our apartment, we are having a problem where the builder went away and we don't have an NOC at all.
Speaking, please. Sorry,
so,
I'm trying to
tell your apartment, sir. Name of the apartment.
This is Akshay Orchid from Sarvangnagar cluster. So we are planning to obtain NOC, So while going through this process, first we should install a fire hydrant, or we can directly apply for NOC, because we don't have a fire hydrant or anything.
No, sir. One of the things I want to suggest is, we do not know really what is the topography of your unit, whether you are a multi-story flat, how many floors, and what kind of fire safety systems are there. This is one reason why I do not know what is it that the builder has done. If you can share some information about it, probably then it becomes helpful for us to come out and say, this is the way we can try to approach your case.
Yeah, my only problem is if we directly approach the authorities without keeping the measures, we can be arm-twisted by them. That is our only worry.
Unfortunately, I want to tell you, sir, we are trying to get feedback from most of the apartments, you know, who have these issues. If you can offline, if you can write a note or send me a specific to your apartment, what are your facilities and what's the nature of your complex? I can possibly see how we can suggest and do that. And if you have an issue, then we can certainly go back to the fire department on your case.
Very nicely placed, Shankar, whatever that has happened so far. And let us invite suggestions and queries from other apartments, as you suggested, so that we could take it up further with the fire department. Any other apartment suggesting something?
Yeah, there is a query from Anil Khalgi. If conveyance has not happened, how KSFES will accept your application?
So I think, Sandhya, one thing is that that's a vague term for me personally. If we know what is the last documentation they have, we can try to understand and go back to the fire department. Whether, conveyance is one thing, but does it mean that NOC is not being obtained? I'm not sure. So that's the thing. Whether they got an initial NOC, they got a final NOC, and subsequent to final NOC, no conveyance has taken place. If that is clear, then we know where we must start.
Thank you, Shankar. Let's reiterate one thing. Actually, the compliance list, we will go through each of those topics in depth, and we'll field questions, but at a later date. After that, we will be sharing this with all the clusters, so that we ask every member to actually go through the entire list and see if they are compliant on each of the topics. And if they are not, actually write down what is it which is preventing them from obtaining this 100% compliance, so that we can collate it and maybe make representations, we can influence policy changes. That is the...
Actually, no. One point I want to make is, the most, our difficult part, you know, in BAF, and maybe for many of us, is whether it is related to lift renewals that Muralidhar Rao was also speaking about, and even as far as fire department is concerned, we would like to request, I find we are about 37 people in this assembly. I want to appeal to each of you, please share full information about your apartment or complex, and then address a mail according to that. Then it makes it easy where we are placed, we will try to understand. We certainly want to help people, but if we have full information, we also feel comfortable and strong to see where we can find answers to, or what approaches we must make.
Shankar, can I suggest something?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you circulate a format, like whatever information that is required, very important to discuss with the fire department, and send it, circulate it. Let us try to get, otherwise you'll start getting all reports, two-page report or half a page report. If you can design some sort of a template where you can get similar information from most of the departments, if they don't send it, we can't help it. We will try to get as many as possible, and then take up, compile those issues and take it up with the fire department. Is it okay?
Yeah, that's perfectly fine, Mr. Nagaraj Rao. But one more thing I also wanted to say was, I don't want to take much of others' time, is that I'm trying to make sure that if I can participate in some of the forthcoming cluster meeting, and then probably elaborate a little more on that. And I will take your suggestion and share a format. It's not difficult to share a format.
Good. I think first if you can send it across, I will definitely tell all the cluster leaders to put up the meetings as already told, in the cluster group so that everybody sees that, and then wherever, whoever is possible can attend. I think it is an important thing if you can attend a couple of them and explain to them what is the requirement. I think first you can kindly, if you can circulate that template, it will be nice so that you get a compiled information in a common format.
Yeah, my only request is then let everybody come up front to say they have a problem and their problem is of NOC or NOC. Surely the form can help. It will be more generic. That's all. Yeah.
Any feedback from any other apartment?
Anyone else has a question?
Yeah. Shankar, you might also want to touch upon the audit you have been conducting for the past couple of months. I think all the members have gone through it, right?
Actually, this is what I'm trying to tell. I'm again appealing to all the cluster groups only for that. Please take part in this fire safety survey. It's a very, very simple survey. Unfortunately, I have not had much traction on this. If we have more feedback and more of the health checks done for apartments, and if you people, most of the people, even who do not have an NOC or a conveyance certificate that I hear that Mr. Sunil is talking, Anil has been talking about, go through a fire, simple fire safety survey. You will have somebody else who understands the fire system to see what is the status of your fire system. And that can determine how well you are placed as far as getting an NOC from fire department is concerned. Conveyance is one thing, certainly I understand. But let us know what is the fire system we have. And it's important that all of us know really what we have. We also must understand that we must get to know our system, how functional they are. Because most of us who have AMCs know the difficulty is when we have a fire incident, the AMC guy is not in our complex. We residents have to face the fire. And so we must have a team and we must have some people, although in every apartment complex, this is a very difficult task. I think sooner or later, you will find the fire department say the fire drill is a very important component for issuing a clearance certificate.
Can I come online?
Yes, please.
Post curtain tower issue, the gazette notification what government has issued, making a fire department as a nodal officer, they have also made it very clear that wherever the building, if they don't have NOC, if the, all the equipments are in a proper position and everything and proper things are available, the fire department is supposed to issue them a clearance certificate.
Okay.
So there is no ambiguity for the fire department to make an audit on that and give a report and complete the task of getting the fire clearance.
Yeah, I only want
the basic problem comes here. The basic problem comes here. The only the owner of the property can approach.
No, sir, this is why I'm trying to come to you. When we had a generic meeting with the Director General end of January also, we are fighting this subject, or this is the topic of discussion from 2018 for the BAF group. So we have put across this. They have said NOCs for apartments which have got issues and which do not have this fire safety clearance, they have to be dealt on a case-by-case basis based on the builder position and the apartment's own position. So that is why you may quote the fire gazette notification. Still, for the fire department, they need a document. So we need to say how we are well placed to really qualify for that. So let us do that documentation. If you have it ready, let's produce and let's ask for it. That's the point I want to make.
If you want a fire equipment audit in your place, you can give a request letter to the RFO, that is a regional fire officer. He is in a position to give the update on this. There is no need, personally, I feel that there is no need to go any consultant and ask for it, and he is meant for that.
Then I'm not talking of a consultant here, sir. I only want you, do you have all the fire safety facilities that are required for a multi-story apartment complex? So if you are satisfied, you will have some document. You will have an NOC that was issued before construction. So if you do not have an NOC after construction, from there you have to only try to study. I don't think we must put too much on an RFO of a local office. Our interest is more paramount. We will have to approach either, if the RFO is not doing it, let us approach the main office. This is the point I want to make. We have to do it a little more proactively, sir.
You got me wrong.
Yeah, tell me.
because the question comes, why I am asking is the issue I have discussed during the period in 2012 and 13 when this gadget notification was issued. Okay. Yeah. Now, later on, it was being made very clear that such association people or promoter of the building approaches. The detail required for that building, also the audit and the details of required installations have to be done. The details will be provided by the RFO, and it is his job. What I mean to say that.
Let us take this offline, because we are not going to come to a conclusion on this. Because we are trying to address this by talking to the, you are the apartment owner, you are suffering.
I understand there are a lot of buildings are there where the NOC's clearance certificates are not there. Maybe NOC is also not there. But if we approach the appropriately the authorities, what I mean to say, there is a possibility of getting the relief.
Then why don't you, I mean, if you have tried it and if you have not got it, then that's the time we can go to the main office.
Yes, precisely.
I do not know why it has not happened so far, but if you think it's still going to work for you, please do that. I am not nobody to stop you on that. If it solves your issue, welcome.
This initiation, Mr. Shankar, I really appreciate.
I have a simple question, sir, here. With due respect and the time which is, you know, getting down, I would like to know that we don't have NOC also in the from the fire department. And what I want to know is that should we proactively go and approach the nearby fire department ourselves, or should we just wait from, you know, any suggestions from the experts within the BAF?
Yeah.
This is Rajendra from GSA Greenwood.
Now, I think we need to talk to you separately, because your problem may be different from what the other person has got. Many people may not have NOC for various reasons. So what is the reason you don't have an NOC is something that must be clear. This is what the main office of the fire department has told us. We will look at it on a case-by-case basis. So if we make a representation, if apartment A makes a representation that it has not got NOC for these reasons, it is not existing in order, then if that letter goes to the Director General's office, surely we should see even the regional fire officer must react. This is my point.
Sure, sir. I think I'll try to take an offline in a discussion with you.
Sandhya, I'm through, ma.
Hello.
If others have no questions.
Yeah. So to summarize what you have said, first, do an audit of the facilities of your fire equipment, etc., which you will be able to facilitate. These are through those Jain University children.
It will be similar to that. It may not necessarily be Jain University, but there is something else coming up. But one more point I want to know. We have available for weekends, every Saturday, we have a team from Usha Armor, and when it strikes, that is available. So they can still do it, three or four apartments every Saturday. This is subject to our current crisis passing over.
Okay. So do that audit and do an audit of your documentation.
Yeah.
See which all you have. Find where are the gaps. Find out, list down what are the issues you are facing, why you don't have those documents. Then sit down with Shankar and then we can take it up higher up.
Correct. I mean, this is the recipe they gave us, Sandhya.
Okay. This also helps us capture all the issues which people are facing. We can see how many what's the percentage of members who are facing these issues.
Maybe they will club similar cases also, and we can have a better assessment and review.
Yes. At this point of time, we don't really have that kind of data. And
no, we have no data.
This will be a critical exercise for each and every member association to do.
Correct.
Murli, are you there?
Done with any more questions, please?
I think Admiral Pillai had a question. Without ownership, how can an association, especially a registered association, take over responsibilities that owners and occupiers are charged with?
I mean, this is a difficult question for me to answer, honestly. If you have a question, if somebody says I have a fire safety issue and I don't have an NOC, I'm prepared to talk to you. So I don't know if the problem is somewhere else, and unless that problem is solved, we can't come to this problem, then it could be a different case.
Okay, Sandhya, if there are no other questions, just summing up, this has been a forgotten case, the fire safety. Unless something else happened elsewhere, then only we think of think of whether we are right. You know, that is the case now, it is starting. Now we are realizing the builder has run away, no NOC and all that. Anyway, I still suggest, Shankar, whatever information that you would like to, basic information you would like to get from the apartments, send it across to them. We will follow it up. Secondly, send it to all the cluster leaders, the communication regarding the audit by that private organization, which will be of some help to us. With these two, we'll be in a position to take it forward with the fire department in general. Of course, this is a particular issue for specific to each apartment, like the building construction itself, but still, some of the general issues can be taken up as you suggested.
Correct.
Okay.
I will address this, Mr. Rao, to the cluster leaders format. And then from there, let it get disseminated. And we can get from cluster leaders which are the apartments in their territory that are in distress on this case.
Yes.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay, Sandhya, can we say bye?
Sure.
We are going to the next meeting at 8 o'clock. The GC meeting.
Oh, right. After this, is it?
Yeah. If there are no other questions, we'll close it. Thank you very much, everyone, for having attended. There are 36 participants. Yeah. Good.
Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Shankar, for having clarified so many points.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Could I make a comment, please? So,
hello.
Can I make a delay?
Shankar?
Yeah.
Shankar?
Yeah, I just want to wind up.
Hello?
Hi, we'll take a 5 minute break and then log in again.
Okay. If there are any queries, please send it to us. We'll discuss it in the GC and come back to you.